Japan is still wrestling with a nuclear crisis 3.5 months after the Fukushima plant began leaking radiation. Today, officials said 34,000 children in the area will be given radiation meters to monitor their exposure. Lucy Kraft went to Fukushima and found that parents there have good reason to be worried.
For 10 years, Akiko Murakami has lived a suburban dream, growing flowers as she raised 4 sons in a leafy corner of Fukushima City. But now she wonders if it's safe to stay here.
Around here.
We brought a Geiger counter to her house.
6.1.
The home she and her husband built for their kids, ages 12 to 21, is surrounded by pockets of radiation, known as hot spots.
I'm always worried about my kids. I'm always thinking about whether I should leave here or not. I'm always thinking about that.
The government has lowered radiation exposure standards in the Fukushima region to 20 millisieverts a year. That's about the same amount as 50 mammograms. Fukushima City is 40 miles from the nuclear plant, the source of the radiation. But Japan is telling its residents that there's no additional risk. Many international experts and even the Prime Minister's former nuclear advisor disagree. They claim that Fukushima is no longer safe, especially for children. Residents traveled to Tokyo to protest after the government loosened safety limits, despite the fact that the long-term impact of low-dose radiation is unknown. The uncertainty has especially affected students.
Watari Junior High School has always stood out for its sports and academic achievements, but now the school has a more dubious distinction, one of the most contaminated schools in all of Fukushima City.
Radiation fears have turned students into shut-ins. With windows firmly closed, girls sweat through kendo sword fighting practice. Meanwhile, what used to be outdoor drills are now held indoors. In the school gym, the soccer team can barely squeeze in games, sharing cramped quarters with the track and field squad. The principal says, "My job is to watch over these kids and help them thrive. But under these conditions, I can't do my job properly. I'm angry and frustrated that there's nothing I can do." The government is trying to do something. Cesium-laden topsoil is now being removed from playgrounds, but in a city of 300,000, it's simply impossible to get rid of it all. So parents who can are voting with their feet. At the Soromame Daycare Center, these are some of the few kids left. Most of the children have moved out of town with their parents. Founder Sadako Momma vows to carry on, but she can't pay her rent anymore. The rest of the world must be thinking, what on earth is wrong with Japan? Where's the sense of crisis, she says. Why isn't our government protecting us? Akiko Murakami, meanwhile, is losing sleep over the worst-case scenario.
My biggest fear is my children's health. I'm worried that after 10 years or 20 years that they would come down with something like cancer. I don't know what. If that happens, I would be the person responsible.
And those fears are moving the family closer toward leaving their home behind. Lucy Kraft, CBS News, Fukushima City.